peace?
I think the reason why people gathered at the legislature today mirrors the reasons why thousands of Canadians have gathered over the last several days, and hundreds of thousands the world over. And that is to raise awareness about the violent massacre and crimes which are being perpetuated by the State of Israel against the people of Gaza, who continue to subsist and live under siege, and the duress and threat of constant and continual violence by the State of Israel in its efforts to ethnically cleanse the Palestinians from that nation state.
Can you tell me something about the kinds of folks who showed up here today?
I think the kinds of folks that showed up here today mirror the very people who have always been involved in organizing around liberation campaigns for the people of Palestine. They are extracted from all religions, whether Muslim, Christian, Jew, and of all cultures, and of all political associations and affiliations. They are united collectively, however, in the fact that they rightly recognize that what has happened to the people of Palestine, what consistently has happened, and what we have seen in the last few days under the rubric of Israel's latest effort, Operation Pillar of Defense, is illicit, morally bankrupt, and does not speak for, I think, the overwhelming majority of Israelis who do want peace in their region and recognize that peace cannot be achieved through violent means.
I have come to realize a long time ago that everything that the Zionists say about the Palestinians, they are actually saying about themselves. It is the Zionists who are, in fact, guilty of every accusation that they level on the Palestinians. The accusation of terrorism, it is the Zionists who are in fact the terrorists. The accusation that Palestinians don't want peace, it is in fact Israel who does not want peace. The accusation that the Palestinians are only acting out of hatred and anti-Semitism, it is in fact the Zionists who are acting out of hatred and racism. The accusation that Palestinians are intent on annihilating Jews, it is in fact the Zionists who are intent on annihilating the Palestinians. Not only on intent on it, they have in fact been doing it. It is the Zionists who are in fact annihilating the Palestinians. They are doing it today as we speak.
You have family in Gaza.
Yes.
Have you heard from them?
I haven't heard from them since the assault started. But it's not hard to imagine what they're going through right now. This latest assault is it's a continuation of the Israel's sort of policy of provocation.
What would you say to people who insist that Israel is just, as our Prime Minister put it, defending themselves against terrorism?
Well, I say to these people, if Israel really wants to defend itself against terrorism, then it should end the occupation. It should lift the siege on Gaza.
We need to encourage and demand, rather, of our Canadian representation, our members of parliament, and all players in the field, that they call for an immediate ceasefire and a halt to the violence which is transpiring between Israel and against Hamas. I think Canada has remained silently complicit by ignoring the situation, and in the other extreme, overtly supportive of Israel's aggression against the people of Palestine. And certainly under the continued and mandated maintenance of the blockade of the Gaza Strip.